Hey, Showbiz Shelly here with the one and only Karamo. I just need to say like the one name. Everybody knows it, right? That's
Exactly.
it. Everybody knows. Hi,
I'm turning
Karamo.
myself into a Beyoncé. No, I'm joking. I'm just joking. No one could be the queen. I'm joking. I'm joking.
Hello, Karamo. How are you doing?
I'm really great. So good to be talking to you.
Oh, I'm so glad to be talking to you, and I feel like there's so much to talk about. Hello, new show. This is like
Hey.
so massive. Of course, everybody knew you, I'm sure, before from Queer Eye, but we're talking, of course, about your daytime talk show. Can you please tell me? I mean, from what I can gather, this has been like a long time in the making. Like, this is something you've always wanted, right?
Yeah, since I was a kid, my only dream was to have my own daytime talk show. So, like,
Wow.
I tell people right now that this is the hard work, this is the dreaming, this is the asking for help, this is being kind to people, this is all the manifestations. Y'all are literally living in my dream right now. But I've always wanted a daytime talk show where I can help people. You know, I help people on Queer Eye. And I think sometimes in daytime TV, it's always about celebrities, which I love a celebrity. I love to talk about, you know, talk and see what celebrities are doing. But when I think about it, at the end of the day, we all go through the same issues with our partners, with our kids, with our mother and our fathers, with our siblings, with coworkers. And no one's really giving us the tools to figure out how to navigate those relationships. And so the fact of the matter is on my show, I just help real people who have challenges in their lives and who have the strength to be vulnerable on TV. Because it's hard to be vulnerable on TV and say, my husband is doing this, my kids are doing that. And so my guests come on and be vulnerable, and I'm gonna listen to them, meet them where they're at, and give them some tools to be better. And it has been working. We are 3 weeks in, it's going great.
Yes.
And so I'm very excited.
Yeah. And so, what would you say are the differences between doing something like Queer Eye and the talk show? What, or do you carry things over from Queer Eye? Because I feel like you kind of do, maybe.
Yeah, of course. Like for me, the things that are carried over is about, like, you know, always connecting, always giving real advice, always having fun. But I think some of the things that are different is that, you know, with Queer Eye, it's a very beautifully packaged story. You know, we get into 1 hour of like solving, you know, everything in the world. Your whole life is just better. And that's because not only the five of us, there's 120 people behind us that make that work. On my daytime talk show, sometimes things don't get solved in quickly. Sometimes I have to offer my guests therapy. Sometimes I have to say, this relationship is not healthy. Let me give you the resources to find the courage to move on to something better. You know, sometimes we've had individuals who I'm like, you know, this won't get resolved because your parents need to be here. Can I invite your parents back? Can I give your parents a call? Because what's going on between you two is deeper. You know, this is something that's laid over from someone else. And now as adults, you think it. And so for me, it's different because, you know, I'm used to just wrapping everything up in a bow in 5 minutes. And for that's not real life. And as much as I love Queer Eye and the work that we do, and I can't wait till our next season, it is also about like showing people like, this is the tool that you can use to at least take the first or second or third step to making your life better in those interpersonal relationships. And so it's been good so far.
Is there a story that maybe they've been on your show already, or maybe there's something coming up that's just like really stuck out to you that just, really got to you thus far?
I would say there's been like three. I'll go through
Yeah.
them quickly. The first
Yes.
one was we had a woman on who her best friend for years, you know, she gained weight from having children and she was loving her body where it was. And this friend felt like he had the power to say to her, like, you know, your body's not right. You know, like you're being lazy and all these things. And like basically body shaming her. And I brought her on my show and celebrated her and celebrated her body and shut him down and made sure people knew that no man, no woman should ever debate a man about her body. That is not something we're going to ever do on my show. And it went viral. You know, I think some of the clips have 10 million views because people were appreciative. There was two Black women who, a mother and a daughter, who were in generational trauma. I mean, like the way that they couldn't communicate. The communication was just bad. And it was because neither of them learned the tools. The mother came from a traumatic household. The daughter picked those things up, tried to be better. And now that it was affecting her relationship. And at the end of the show, I convinced these two Black women to go to therapy that I would pay for them. And you could see the hesitation of them because a lot of times in the Black and Latino community, there's a hesitation about going to therapy. And for them to trust me and to use my tools to go to therapy, I was blown away. And so we do stuff like that. We had a story that came on about a young girl who was, everyone was calling her a wild teen and she's crazy and she's whatever. And when I brought her out, I said, this is not a wild teen. We're not going to label this young woman who has not felt love from her father and who's making choices based on that. We're not going to call her a wild teen. We're going to call her a young girl who's looking for love. And we're going to call her a young girl who needs us to rally around. And this young girl decided that she wanted to get help, that she wanted to be better, because I didn't bring her on the show to make her feel even worse. I brought her on the show to say, I understand that this is not your fault. You got born into a family where your father didn't have the courage to love you and to be there for you. And now you're paying the price of that, but we're here to pick up that slack and support you. And so those three stories alone,
so I'm telling good.
You, girlfriend, we over here having fun. We're doing jobs, work.
I know. And I remember, I think I saw that, the first one you mentioned about the woman who was shamed about her body after having a baby. And so it kind of segues me to the next thing, because I have a 4-month-old.
Oh my gosh, congratulations.
Thank you. I know she's the best. And I know you have a kids book coming out. So tell me about it. I want to hear.
Yes, my kids book is called I'm Okay to Feel. It's my second kids book. My first one, my son, is called I Am Perfectly Designed. The second one is called I'm Okay to Feel. And the reason I wrote this book with my son is because I think a lot of times we don't know how to talk to our kids about their emotions. And then we become adults that feel like we have to walk through life saying, I'm fine. Every time someone says, how are you doing? I'm fine.
I'm good.
Fine. I'm okay. All is great. And it's because we're taught, like, don't be a burden. Your emotions are a burden. And so I want to write a book that could show kids, like, no matter if you're happy, sad, excited, frustrated, anxious, all of those emotions are valid. And none of those emotions are a burden on other people. It's not saying that, like, people have to solve your problems. This is one of the things that I tell people all the time on my show. It's people, we don't need you to solve my problems. I don't go to people to solve my problems. But it is nice to acknowledge that we're human beings and we're all not just perfect walking through this world. I woke up this morning and I was like, I promise you, if you would have caught me an hour and a half ago,
It was bad.
It seemed like everything was crumbling. And I had someone who could acknowledge that and allow me just to discuss it without me pretending. And now I'm bright and airier. And so the book is about, like, just teaching your kids it's okay to feel. And not only is a great story between this father and son, but at the end of the book, I actually give clinical resources in a tangible way so that parents can actually say, oh, this is what I'm supposed to do. And I wrote it to my son, Jason, come quick.
Jason, where is he?
Hi. My son. We signed
a contract.
I'm sitting on your lap like Santa.
It's so cute. Oh, I love it. So this is my baby.
So he wrote it with me. He wrote both books and I'm pretty proud of it. So can you see that?
I mean, that's part of his, gosh, I gotta be honest with you. My father was a strict but great dad at the same time.
Oh, I'm so strict, y'all.
Let me let you know right now. I would have homework and then I would have dad homework. So I would have to come home, do my regular schoolwork, and then dad would have his.
Oh, let me tell you this.
Let
me tell you something, because I noticed early on that my son had a talent for expressing himself in writing. So I would make him write stories as dad homework before he went out.
Yeah.
And it could be about anything. And guess who became a best-selling author at 24?
Okay.
So dad homework was working.
Why do you just give me ideas? I love that, because I was just telling Karamo Jason that I have a 4-month-old daughter. So I'm thinking of now, like, all these things that I want to implement that. I love that.
Seriously. And so, you know, like, of course, kids are like, why do I have to do, you know, whatever. But the thing was, is that as parents, we see in our kids what, like, the things that they're interested in. And so I was like, let me just foster this in a way that's going to give you the skills for later on. Yeah, so
you saw way more than I saw myself.
At he did. Yeah. So
100 pages more.
That's what we want from our parents, right? I feel like I have so much more to ask you. I have like this whole sheet of stuff, but I know you have to run. So I don't know. Is there anything else you want to add? We have the same birthday, by the way, Karamo, coming up.
November 2nd.
Yes.
Let's go, Scorpio sister!
I know. What are you doing for your birthday? Anything?
By the way, Scorpio women are better than Scorpio men. We're trash, but you all are amazing.
Wow.
That's so funny. Any plans for your birthday or no?
Not sure yet. I actually shoot my show on my actual birthday, which is the best gift ever. You know, shooting my show. But my partner, his birthday, his name is Carlos. His birthday is November 1st, and I'm November 2nd.
Oh.
So hopefully we'll do something. You didn't know that?
No.
Yeah. So, well, he's like, oh. So, you know, usually last year at midnight, we did something together.
Oh,
and so
cute.
Probably at midnight, 11:59 at midnight, we'll probably like have our little dinner or something. Sweet. We'll see. Aww. What are you doing?
I don't know. I think, so I have a friend who also, her birthday's close to mine. She also just had a baby. So we might do like something together. I don't know. We're trying to figure it out, but
it's
yeah.
It's so weird. Like back in the day, it was always like, I'm going to the club and I'm partying.
Right?
And it's like, yeah, we're going to have a dinner and go to sleep. And that's
how
it.
How much pain. I know.
Exactly.
I know. Well, Karam, I'm so happy for you. And your show's on noon in Chicago on the CW. So we're just, like I said, maybe you can come back sometime. I'd love to talk to you more.
I would love to any time. Thank you for having me, honestly.
No, thanks for coming and good to meet you, Jason.